hello, my friends, and welcome. Rodney Warren here, author and CEO of Elite Force Marketing. In this video, you'll get and fully understand exactly what the number one killer mistake is that is being unwittingly made by 90% of the people that fail to make it in a successful online business. That's right, the number one terrible mistake. And then I'd like to let you in on some secrets that will effectively abolish that deadly mistake, if you choose to take some action steps necessary to succeed. So what is it? What is the number one specific mistake unwittingly made that kills 90% of new online business ventures? By online business, that could mean MLM network marketing, internet marketing like affiliate marketing, or your own product creation and informational marketing. Heck, it could even mean promoting your own local small business or your mom and pop brick and mortar business. Well, it really doesn't matter. For the brand new entrepreneur just starting out, the number one thing preventing, hampering, and sabotaging so many people from really even getting started the success that I know you're capable of drills down to one major factor. And I'll let you in on that right now. Are you ready for the truth? It's self-doubt. That's right, a lack of belief in oneself. That is what it is, self-doubt. So why is self-doubt so prevalent? And more importantly, in this video, we'll go into some details on what we can do about it so that hopefully you can change self-doubt into something much more positive so you can get some momentum and start seeing success in your online business and in your daily life. Now, the reason that self-doubt is so debilitating and really paralyzing is that when one is in the state of self-doubt, they don't take action. That's right, they don't take action. And everyone that's successful in this industry knows full well that you must, I mean you must, take action. Full-on, hard-hitting, no playing around action. Come on, if this is the game, then why do 90% of the people fail to take action? Well, it's again because people doubt themselves. And as we'll discover, they're missing a few critical game-changing secrets, as I'll share in a moment. People just seem to feel unworthy, and that creates doubt in themselves. Unworthy, I say, heck, if you even knew a portion of who you are as a human being, and moreover, what you and I are really capable of, my friend, you definitely would not find yourself unworthy. In fact, I'd like to wash you clean of any bad past experiences and feelings of unworthiness right now. I mean, this may be a little bit hard-hitting, but really, for all intent and purposes, cut the crap and the negative thinking. I'm here to tell you that not only are you worthy, but you are successful waiting to happen and to shine, as I'll explain in this video, with the help of a few great teachers, of course. But first, back to taking action and actually following through. So for this video, I went straight to the top industry professionals to find some answers for you, answers to the questions of what it is that gets people to take action and gets people to follow through. Now, some of you may be familiar with Tony Robbins, Frank Kern, and John Reese. I call these three the three wise men. Now, these men really need no introduction, but if you're not familiar, Tony Robbins is the most popular teacher and speaker on the vast subjects in personal development, including taking action and motivation, to say the least. Now, Frank Kern and John Reese are the planet's top internet marketers. Well, the three of them had a closed-door meeting that I'd like to let you in on. The meeting had to do with the subjects of human character flaw, if you will, when taking action and getting the job done. And I'll explain as best I can, some of the life's gold lessons that transpired from that meeting just over a year ago. And as the story goes, John and Frank found themselves discouraged that all the effort they took to create great life-changing informational products was almost for naught. I mean, people bought the courses and products, but many did not take action and in turn see results. And they explained to Tony that in fact, many people were excited to get their courses and other leading industry professionals' courses as well and their materials, but many of the courses ended up unopened on a shelf to collect dust. Well, Frank and John went to Tony to find out why. Why aren't people taking action? After Tony listened to the plight of the baffled and somewhat bewildered men, he had a diagram in his hand, a chart, if you will, that held the answer to the strategy to overcome this very virtue. When it comes to motivation and action, you see, Tony has studied this character for years and has traveled the globe and personally talked to tens, even hundreds of thousands of people to try to figure this stuff out. For now, we're just going to move from this beautiful video shoot here back to the office, and I'm going to fire up the whiteboard, and I'm going to let you in on that diagram that Tony had in his hand, and I'm going to explain in detail, kind of in my own words, what he said, and hopefully that'll help you out. So come on inside, and we'll just shoot this rest of this on the whiteboard. Tony had explained it something like this. He said, "Gentlemen, this is not a small problem. And in my studies of human behavior, I found that it's the same reason that some overweight people keep going back for more chocolate, even though they hate the way they look in some cases. Or why the person diagnosed with lung cancer goes for yet another cigarette in 70% of the cases studied. But there is an answer, because there are successful people. For example, there are some people that never have followed through on anything in their life, and then suddenly they break through." And he said, "That's what I focus on. What did those people do?" So what do you do with those people that have a mental block of uncertainty? Tony went on then to talk about changing your state, both mentally and or your physical state, asking us to think of how you felt or what you were thinking the last time that you or I ever accomplished anything great, like winning an award or doing something heroic. Remembering that state and utilizing that same energy the next time you need to embark on a new adventure, or if you're an athlete, needing to be at peak performance. Tony calls this changing your physiology. He then mentioned that a little test that was conducted with some basketball player athletes. They took one group of guys and they had to do intense practice for 6 weeks. They had to do so many free throw exercises and that kind of thing. Then the second group was not to practice at all. Okay? And then they took the third group, and their requirement was to practice but without touching the ball. No, this group practiced with their mind. But you know, the key is that they say practice makes perfect. But as corny as it may sound, actually perfect practice makes perfect. So these guys see themselves making the shot every single time, conditioning their mind and their body that is perfect every time. They're not interrupted by any reality that may screw with them. So at the end of 6 weeks, they tallied everything up, and now they give them a test to see who has the highest free throw percentage, to see who has the best success. So what do you guess it's going to be? Well, obviously it's not the guys that didn't practice, but which one is it? The mind, or the ones that actually practiced? Well, if your guess was the ones that conditioned their mind, then your intuition was right. To conclude then, really, practice isn't merely enough. It's getting yourself so certain, so many times, that now when you go and do it, there's no hesitancy, and you go and execute the move. So here's where the success model, the diagram that Tony had in his hand, comes into play. And here it is on my whiteboard. It's having absolute belief and certainty that makes you tap into your full potential, which in turn makes you take massive action, and that reinforces stronger belief and gets results. And this is what makes you a star at anything. Remember, where focus goes, energy flows. Now be careful, because not only can you see great things happen using this model, but adverse or opposite effects can be true if things start going in reverse. If you don't have strong enough beliefs to create the certainty enough to take action, then you won't get the results that you require, and your belief is going to go downhill. So, does that make sense? So really, it's about having a crystal clear vision about what you want, who you want to be, how much money you want to make, and when, what kind of car you want to drive. What education do you want for yourself or your loved ones? Where would you like to travel? And start taking small daily action steps toward that goal or dream, all the while believing that the outcome is already in your possession. In short, Belief is the holy grail to creating momentum. Now that you know what you want to achieve, believe that you've achieved it. And that will create certainty, which again taps into your potential, which spurs you to take action and get results. Now, many of you know this process actually is being coined the law of attraction. The one way of believing that you've achieved a desired outcome and start to manifest it in your life before to actually achieving it is really quite simple. The way that my family and I like to keep our goals and dreams steadfast before us is through the use of vision boards. And I brought my vision board in to show you. It's basically all your goals and aspirations cut out of magazines and pasted on some construction paper, then put in a place that you can see it daily. Mine hangs right beside my bed, posted on the wall to revisit a couple of times a day. So let's talk very briefly about this law of attraction and how it can create belief and certainty in your life. Do you want a great love life, plenty of friends, lots of money? Who doesn't, right? The law of attraction is what most dominant in what you're thinking of, or your vibration. In other words, your vibrational escrow. Heavy duty words, right? Any thought that you can think causes you to offer a vibration. When you offer a vibration because of that thought, the law of attraction responds to that thought, and very soon thereafter attracts to it similar thoughts, good or bad, positive or negative. Soon these thoughts manifest and become who you are. In short, that's the law of attraction. Really, the trick is to quickly discourage bad thoughts and replace them with good ones. So what is the doorway of the mind that the law of attraction enters? Well, quite simply, the entrance way to really manifest a positive mental energy or vibration is appreciation. Appreciate what is and be satisfied with where you are, and you'll allow things to come into your life. Appreciation is to increase the value of your life. If you want more, think of that of which you want as already being in your possession, as I've said. Reaching for thoughts that feel better. Appreciation is the absence of everything that feels bad, and focus on everything that feels good. In other words, attracting more of what you want and less of what you don't want. The law of attraction simply states that I attract to my life whatever I give my attention, energy, or focus to. The law of attraction is a law because it always responds the same. In other words, negative thoughts attract negative things, and conversely, positive thoughts always attract more of the same. So when things that happen that are good, then celebrate. But here's the catch. If in our life on a day-to-day basis, especially in this economy and whatnot, there's a good chance that bad things may occur. And this is where discipline of your mind comes to play, you see. It's your and my responsibility to drive negative away with positive affirmation. I say responsibility because really it's our ability to respond in a positive manner. Remember, the law of attraction makes no distinction between the good and the bad. It merely gives back what is given. Now, all this should keep your mind busy for a while. So my question to you is, what's your vibrational escrow, or what are you attracting to you? Well, take a look around you and you'll find a perfect match. Well, there's no reason to question why it is that these fundamental truths will definitely help explode your business and give you the mindset needed to follow through and give you what you need for making money and having online success and success in life in general. So what's the takeaway? Well, I'd like to take and get you to build a vision board of your own right after this video. Then go through some old magazines, cut out some pictures or words that best represent your desired outcomes, like I've done, and now glue them pictures onto some construction paper, and voila, you have a goal or vision board. Now hang it beside your bed, and believe me, good things will start to happen. Hey, if you think it sounds loopy, then go check out Napoleon Hill's Think and Grow Rich. He talks all about conditioning the mind for success. Or check out The Secret with Bob Proctor. Again, all about conditioning yourself for success. Just like a fighter preparing the body and mind for battle. So go down to the bottom of this here video, download the PDF version of Tony's success model that I've artistically created for you, and then go straight to work on your vision board. And if you can, check out Napoleon Hill's Think and Grow Rich or Bob Proctor's The Secret. They should be in any bookstore. So without further ado, I'm going to get to work and get on your next video and get it all ready for you. You won't want to miss out on the next video. That, believe me, will help you out as much, if not more, with your making money online with internet marketing. Please do me a great favor and comment on this video down below and ask what it is that you'd like to hear me speak about, like a frustration you're having with your online marketing right now. I'd really appreciate it. And I get back to all my comments and blogs. So until next time, live with compassion, give generously, and seize life's opportunities. We'll see you soon.